Hello students of 6th standard, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 4, disaster management. See, there are some events given in your textbook. So what is this events tells us? See, there is in the first picture there is an earthquake of a building, then again there is a, you can say, rain is there, volcano is there, then again fire of the forest is there, various you can see things are given. See, what events do you see in this picture? We see these various pictures. Then see, what do you have done in such situations? There are, you can say, various, you can say, types, or you can say by following various things, we can get rid of these situations. Then see, have you experienced such a situation yourself? Yes, we have experienced the situations of such yourself. That is nothing but ourselves we have experienced. Why do these events occur? These events occur due to the, you can say, disasters created in the nature. Then see next one, disaster. In July 2014, the whole village of Mali and Ambegaon taluka of Pune district was destroyed in a matter of minutes due to the landslide. There was a, you can say, landslide, and due to which the, you can say, whole village of Mali, which is present in the Ambegaon Pune, that was destroyed, and it was due to the landslide. Many got buried under the heaps of soil and stone and lost their life. Many of the peoples lost their life because they were buried under the landslide, or you can say under the ground or under the soil. Then see, in November 2015, many peoples died due to the flooding caused by heavy rains in the Tamil Nadu. There was heavy rain in the Tamil Nadu in 2015, and many, you can say, peoples, they have lost their life. In 1993, many people died due to the earthquake in the Killari in Latur district, which is, the Killari is one of the, you can say, village which is present in the, you can say, Latur district, and this was also made with an earthquake, and many peoples have lost their life in this disaster. Even today, people of Mumbai shudder at the memory of, you can say, July 2005, when many people had lost their lives in the, you can say, Delhi caused by the heavy rains. There was a, you can say, heavy rains in 2005 in Mumbai. Today also the peoples are afraid of this, you can say, incident. How and why do the following disaster occur? See, floods occur due to the heavy rains, earthquake, lightning, volcano eruption. See, then see, forest fire. There are, you can say, disasters which are occurred due to the forest fire. Increased risk due to the high density of population in the limited area. Then again see, rampant and irregular construction. There is a irregular construction which is seen in the, you can say, various cities. Ecological imbalance. There is an ecological imbalance. Then see, terrorism, riots and crimes resulting in bomb explosion, or you can say assaults, fires and accidents. All these create a disaster. And see, now, classify the following disasters as man-made or a natural. Fire is nothing but a man-made disaster. Then again, leakage of chemical gas, that is also due to the man-made disaster. Storms, that are natural disaster. Floods, they are also natural disaster. Tsunami, they are also natural disaster. Bomb explosion, that is man-made disaster. Collapse of building, that is also, it is a man-made disaster. War, then see, it is nothing but a man-made disaster. Forest fire, it is also man-made disaster. Now see, disaster of disasters are of two main kinds. They are nothing but man-made and natural. Further, we are going to see the earthquakes. See here, movements in the interior of earth release tremendous amounts of energy. Whenever there is a movement in the interior of the earth, there is a, you can say, release of amounts of energy. This causes systemic waves. There is, you can say, cause of a systemic waves, which is leading to the movements of the earth's surface, like tremors, shaking or cracking. See, there is a, you can say, this systemic waves causes the movements of the earth's surface. There is a movement of the earth's surface, and due to this, what happens? The earth's surface, there will be the movements in the earth surface, and due to this there will be shaking or cracking of the earth. Such vibrations are quaking in the earth's crust. Whenever you see such vibrations are quaking in the earth's crust is known as an earthquake. This, you can say, seismic waves, or whichever the tremendous release of the tremendous amount of energy from the earth, that is called as a earthquake. It is believed that beside other causes, man-made causes, see, beside other causes, we know that there are natural causes, but beside that there are man-made causes also, that are nothing but mining and construction of big dams can also lead to the earthquake. See, earthquake can be also caused due to the mining or you can say construction of the dams. Then comes the flood. A frequently occurring natural disaster in all parts of the world is nothing but a flood. Due to the excessive rain, whenever you see there is an excessive rain in the same places, or you can say river flows in banks causing a flood. Whenever there is a more amount of rain in a particular area, what happens? The rivers get flooded and there comes a flood. The water drainage system in the big cities falls short. So what happens? The water drainage system fails there. And when there is a, this happens when there is a heavy rainfall. Resulting, what happens? There is a, you can say, some problems in the gutters. The gutters will choke. The drainage lines will also choke. Water overflows on the roads and surrounding areas and even enters the nearby houses. This is caused due to the flood. Then see, what are the effects of the flood? Huge loss of life and property. Whenever you see there is a huge loss of life and property, there is a soil erosion due to the flood, destruction of standing crops, there will be, you can say, problem in the crops whichever are standing, there will be loss in the crops. Then see, after effects of the flood, like spread of disease, epidemics affecting the health of the people. Whenever there are floods, there is also cause of the disease. After the flood has gone, there will be the disease which are caused to the man, or you can say animals. This is nothing but the health problem which is caused to the man. Then see, next comes the storms. The formation of high and low air pressure. Whenever there is a formation of low and high pressure, so what happens in the atmosphere causes change in the weather, resulting in the strong winds, or you can say in the storms. So what are the effects of the storms? See here, great damage in the storm affected region. The region where the storm has affected, there will be the great loss in that region. Tremendous losses of the life and property, the property and the lives, most of the peoples, you can say, lost their life. Then see, disruption of electrical supply. There is no electrical supply due to the storms. Then C, disruption of transport and communication system. As there are storms, what happens? The roads get damaged. You can say electricity supply also gets damaged due to this. The transport and communication, whichever is seen in a trade, in the various trade, this also gets damaged. Then see next one, forest fires. Forest fire is nothing but an uncontrolled thing in the forest. So you can see pasture or grassland. Due to natural or man-made causes, the fire to the forest may cause naturally or it may also cause due to the man-made. Then see, it may be due to the man-made causes also. This forest fire, you can say, spreads within a tremendous speed. Once the forest has been laid on the fire, then tremendously it spreads over all of the forest. Forest, effects of a forest fire. Great damage to the natural wealth. Whatever the natural wealth is there, that is greatly affected. The plants, the animals and various varieties, whatever are present in the forest, they all get, that means the biodiversity gets damaged there. Then also due to the large release of the smoke, there will be pollution of the air. Then see, can you tell how many children are there in your class at present? Then see, what would happen if 5 minutes this number stay in your class? Then see, what kind of disaster can occur in extremely crowded places? See, there is a disaster management. Whenever you see, community participants and disaster management are very closely related to each other. Then see, taking steps to prevent the disaster. We have to take some steps to prevent the disaster. We have to make plans for the sake of the disaster, how to face the disaster or how to develop the capacity for that. This all is called as a disaster management. To prevent or to reduce the disaster management is our duty, and whatever the man-made disasters are there, or you can say emergency planning and management is required, that should be made by the man himself.